that is the scene everyone's waiting for. Just if you're wondering, the woman sitting there in the front is Emma Probert, who is Catherine's personal bodyguard. Michael in the back there making himself comfortable. And if you won't notice there as Catherine waves, there's an awful lot of train in there as well for people to enjoy. Catherine Middleton on her way to become the daughter-in-law of that couple who are just in shot. She is wearing the engagement ring of Diana. William said, bringing together the two most special women in my life. Her Majesty the Queen had to give approval for this wedding under the 1772 Royal Marriages Act, in which she said she approved of the wedding of our most dearly beloved grandson, Prince William, and our well-beloved Catherine. And that is the Rolls-Royce carrying Catherine Elizabeth Middleton and a very, very proud father, Michael Middleton, on the way to the Abbey. She looks behind that veil a picture of contentment, a confident wave which we saw yesterday when she arrived at this hotel. She is now about 7 minutes away from Westminster Abbey and a total fundamental change to her life. The courtship over, the flirtation with the press over. That young woman is about to become Princess William of Wales. Catherine Middleton, Kate to the family, soon to be Her Royal Highness to the rest of us. Six outriders, she'll get used to that. A Range Rover behind with bodyguards, she'll get used to that. But she spoke to Tom Bradbury about the daunting prospect of joining the royal family. From everything we've seen and heard today, they will welcome her to their bosom. Whether Andrew Neil is right or wrong, I don't know. But just listen to those crowds. They want her. They look forward to having her as a part of a royal family. On her way now to the Abbey. On her way to becoming the wife of Prince William and the future Princess William of Wales. A beautiful smile, a beautiful bride-to-be.
Breathtaking shots.
The most breathtaking view of the bride. And the cheer goes up behind us.
Those are magical shots that will be seen around the world, and quite rightly, everyone will say, wow.
Yard the train.
Sure, doesn't she?
She looks very, very
smiling
happy.
Away.
Oh, look, here are the bridesmaids.
The pages arriving, waiting, just a not long to wait now before the bride arrives. Pippa Middleton in a beautifully sleek, elegant dress.
The little bridesmaids could have been bridesmaids over the last 10, 15 years. Classic, traditional little girls' dresses.
She looks fantastic.
Pippa looks amazing.
They look like they could misbehave too. It's going to be interesting.
Apparently they're going to be taken away. The littlest ones might be moved away.
We're hoping for a bit of misbehaving, aren't we?
We like that.
I think when a lot of people are looking for a new Diana, but Kate is very different from Diana. Diana was really a young girl when she got married. This is a young woman. Yeah. This is a woman who's well educated. Diana had, I think, won all level.
And comes from a happy family.
Comes from a stable, happy family. Diana didn't. It's much more in a sense a marriage of equals.
And we can see that happiness radiating, can't we, as she waves to the crowds.
She's just enthusiastic. She's having a lovely time and it shows, and there's nothing more appealing than somebody just enjoying the moment. She's not getting her knickers in a twist. She's just happy and having a lovely time, and that's really appealing, isn't it?
Well, everybody standing here behind us, the million people lining the route, all wanted that shot of the dream princess.
Yeah.
And we've only seen a glimpse so far of what she will
do. But she hasn't let us down, has she?
But absolutely, she hasn't let us down.
So a beautiful bodice.
Lace, that sort of lace. Couture lace, it looks like.
It looks very similar to Princess Grace of Monaco's. Do you remember that very famous dress?
I do.
That a lot of people take inspiration from.
And the most delicate of veils. And we can still see her beautifully, can't we?
I wonder whose tiara she's wearing. I wonder if that's not the Spencer tiara.
There somewhere. Still waiting for information on that TRES.
Wonderful little snapshot there of all four of the little bridesmaids.
I wonder how much they'll remember.
Just out of Horse Guards Parade and out to be welcomed by the crowds in Whitehall.
Interestingly, that photographer we saw taking pictures of Kate getting into the car has been hired by Kate and William personally to take personal pictures just for them. She's called Millie Pilkington, I think.
Is that
old
usual?
Friend. I think for a bride and groom in this situation, nothing is usual. and so they wanted their own private pictures.
Well, that's another very personal touch, isn't it?
But the other interesting thing as they go through Westminster Abbey is it will be very personal because there's no one else up those two steps at the end.
Well, what's fantastic also is that as our future princess, soon to be Her Royal Highness, drives towards her wedding at the Abbey, for the first time this morning, the sun's come out.
And it's impossible to imagine what words of advice a father might have for this particular bride.
Stay calm,
on an occasion like this.
I think he might be a lot more nervous than she is.
Yeah. Well, it's certainly the case that she looks supremely happy
remarkable.
And relaxed. It is remarkable, isn't it?
But she always has. I mean, you used to see William and Harry falling out at nightclubs at 4 a.m. You never saw her. She was there, but she was always immaculately composed.
Correct.
No matter what the time.
But with lovely friends who stayed discreet, even through the split that
they
we
haven't.
All were lived through, they kept quiet.
The media hasn't even been able to use that tried and tested machine of friends close to Kate say that. Even that, you haven't heard a word out of
and that's
there.
And that's the two of them. They're determined, aren't they, to keep their lives bits of it private.
It's very different when you think what the royal family's been through over the past 20 years. This is very different.
Let's listen to the crowd as she arrives at the Abbey.
It's 11 o'clock. The bells are ringing. And these are the last few moments when Kate Middleton will be Kate Middleton.
Miss Kate Middleton.
She is wearing brand Alexander McQueen. It is a wedding dress that has been designed, as was speculated, by Sarah Burton. So if you imagined a fairy tale princess and her dress, is that the picture you had in your mind? I think perhaps it might have been.
It is the sight, after all these months of build-up and speculation, that many have been longing for, and she's taking a moment to give the crowd a wave.
Her team have said that the dress epitomises timeless British craftsmanship by drawing together talented and skilled workmanship from across the United Kingdom.
Middleton at the top of the aisle of Westminster Abbey, the place she will leave as a princess. James Mates is our guide to the service.
On the arm of her father and led by the Dean of Westminster, the bride will pause briefly. Any final adjustments that need to be made? her maid of honour, and the rest is I know is happy.